So we are back in the pumpkin patch, which is the back garden behind the corn. And I am just getting some pumpkins that are ready. I had picked a few the other day just because they were kind of starting to get ready, and I thought I'll throw them on the stand. And turns out we sold them, so I'm just picking a few more to throw out there. This one's looking good. So we're back in the back garden, just checking on my pumpkins, seeing if any of them are ready. Pumpkins are generally ready mid-September all the way through October. So let's see what we have. This one's rotting. We'll feed it to the chickens. I'm also, as I'm checking on the pumpkins, I'm gonna just rotate them a little bit to make sure they aren't getting too flat on one side. And then also if there's dying leaves, I'll prune those back. Obviously not all of them, but like this and stuff. There's no use leaving that on there because it just drains from the growth of the pumpkin. So I do have one ready here. They become easier to pick once they're ready. It's a little silly shaped, but pumpkin's a pumpkin. These are, I think they're called pepta pumpkins. You can just cut them open and eat the seeds right out of them. This one over here is ready. That one's looking nice. The girls a little treat here. Go put these up on the stand. I would like to just note for one time I actually remembered my gardening gloves. So there's that. So on the way to the stand, we are passing the mystery plant, which we kind of just let grow all summer. If you've watched our previous videos, it ends up being a honeydew melon, which is almost ready to harvest. So the way that happened was I threw seeds out to the chickens when they were free range. And one of them wiggled their way into the cracks of our cement. And now we have delicious honeydew melon, which was a nice surprise. So I'm glad that we let this plant just grow, because we'll probably eat it for dinner here in a couple of days. So I'm back here in the greenhouse, well actually outside of it, and because of this new stylish ventilation, it makes it easier to get in and out, so there's that. But I'm back here picking some peppers because I decided we're going to have fajitas for dinner, so we're going to use fresh tomatoes and fresh peppers. So, wish I had my loppers. Ooh, that one's not as pretty as I thought. So we got this nice one here. That'll be good. Got this one right here. And then I think we'll throw in some jalapenos for a little bit of spice. So we're gonna go right down here. A couple of them. So it should be a pretty good dinner. Nothing better than fresh from the garden vegetables. We are in the back garden doing some harvesting today. We're doing zucchinis and cucumbers. Zucchinis will keep growing until first frost. They're looking good. Which first frost, you never really know in Minnesota. Sometimes it's early, sometimes it's late. Hoping for a later one. Looks like our little cantaloupe's looking good too. Super teeny, but they actually are ripening pretty well. Probably a little bit longer. He's looking good. Well, there's one over here we neglected. So this is what happens when you miss a day. Still can eat it though. It's good for breads when they get that big. It's another good one. Another good one. They taste way better when they're smaller. I've said that in other videos. But a lot of people like them bigger because I feel like they think they're getting more for their money. But they actually are the most flavorful when they're about this size. I think that's good for zucchini for now. So we got a whole basket full of those. Gonna move on over to cucumbers over here. We've already picked, I don't know, 4 baskets full this week of cucumbers. And I mean overflowing baskets. Nice odd shaped one. Cucumbers are kind of like zucchinis in the way if you miss a day, they get huge. Oh, this one's perfect. This is exactly where I like. That's like a perfect size cucumber. They're not too big and watery. And they're just a good size for salads and things. If you wait too long on cucumbers, they when you cut into them, they're just watery. This one's got a little pumpkin in it. So many lemon cucumbers. They grow so well. So well. There's a nice regular one. Perfect size. Some more lemons. I'm gonna have to go back to my bucket here. I'm gonna throw some to the chickens. More chicken treats. So Shane's been working on the fence, taking it down. How's it going?
Oh, good. Yeah, it'd be nice to get this out of here. We'll start bundling the corn up.
It's looking good.
I can't believe how much the weeds have grown into it, though.
Yeah, it is a bit of a mess.
Hey, all right. Oh, my golf ball.
Nice. It's amazing all the things you find when the season's over and you start tearing things down, like scissors in the chicken coop, golf balls wrapped in weeds.
Did you want to try to make it go around the garden, or do we care?
Yeah, I mean, we can do that. That'd be fine. Okay. Or I don't know. Maybe we don't wrap it, because we don't have enough to go around the chaos garden, so I don't know if we can let the chickens out yet. What are your thoughts?
I'm just thinking let's just tie it back.
Okay.
Tie it back here and double it up. That way it's secured, and then we can take it down when we take down everything at the end of the year.
Okay, sounds good. Sounds like less work, so I'm on board for that.
Yeah, exactly. A lot less work.
This fencing really worked out great this year, though. As far as keeping the animals out, I think we should get more of it next year, and then we don't have to have the chickens locked up at all. It would be nice.
Yeah, I agree. It's expensive.
Yeah, that's the only downside.
It's expensive and it's kind of brittle.
Yeah.
But it did what I thought it would do, so.
Easiest way to take down corn, Sawzall. Just like that. So we'll do all of these rows and then the kids will bundle them up. And then we'll put them up on the stand for a nice fall decoration. They always look good around pumpkin season. And
how many of these did you want to tie up? Maybe like 10?
Yeah.
All right.
Probably good. Yeah.
Van's overcutting all the other ones, so.
So the boys went to the store to get some materials for one of our projects. So me and Libs here are gonna start working on the corn again. We had to take a little bit of a break because it was pretty hot today. But anyways, so the boys are out shopping and we're gonna do all the hard work, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's get going.
So my mom's cutting the corn so then I can go stack them and tie them into string and then go put them on the stand.
We're out here working in the corn and our little visitor just always has to be right by me. Say hi, Deuce. Pumpkins are doing so good in that back little section. I figured we'd come over to Chaos Garden and just kind of see where we're at with pumpkins over here because we have so many more plants and they're so much bigger and healthier looking in Chaos Garden. And I'm pleasantly surprised that they are ginormous. We've got some really big ones growing in here, starting to orange up, so they'll be ready for Halloween. And they're kind of buried all up in here. There's another one right here. Looking good. The only downside to this garden is it's so thick. It's hard to find them, but they're in there. There's another one right, three right here next to each other. One, two, and then one down in there hidden. Can't take more than a foot without running into another one. Here's another one. Another little one growing in here. I think we're gonna have a really good harvest just out of from this section. So probably in the next 2 weeks, we'll harvest all of them and start putting them out. I'm pretty sure that even when we get through all of these, and I think I have them all picked, we'll probably find a ton more when I get through here. Some other little ones budding up. Those will be late bloomers. Those will be good for pumpkin pies around Thanksgiving. Another little one. We're very fortunate to have as many bees as we have. I mean, you can't look anywhere right now and not see some bees, which is important for pollination, obviously. You can self-pollinate pumpkins by grabbing a male and a female and rubbing them together yourself. But it's a lot less work when nature does it for you. So I suggest always get flowers in your garden because they're gonna attract bees. And also, I know people hate them, but dandelions are so, so very important because they're one of the first blooming flowers in the seasons that bees use to pollinate for. So I'm one of those odd people that likes dandelions and I just let them grow naturally. We don't do anything with them because they're very important for the bees. Another really good sized one right here. A couple of them actually. One back in there. Woo, look at this beauty. Goes all the way down to here. That's a gorgeous one. Like I said, I'm pretty excited for the next couple of weeks to see how these grow and start ripening. So keep an eye out for that video. We'll probably call it pumpkin harvest or something. A couple more right back in here. Ooh, here's another beaut. Look at the size of that one. Perfect. Little guy right in here. One of them little white ones. Oh, another monster over here. Oh, this one's huge. Another good one right here. Now, I don't often venture through in there too much, but there is, by the looks of how many on the outside, I think it's gonna be really exciting when we get to harvest time and I actually get in there and see how many there are. Couple good sized ones. One's looking good. Another one right in here. Littler ones. Oh, I mean, that's probably just 30 on the perimeter, I would say. I have no idea how many are. Hopefully like 100, but that might be wishful thinking, but at least 50, if not more. I would say. I think it's got a lot of hidden ones that I'm probably, because they're still green, so sometimes it's kind of hard to find them with all the vegetation. So I think when they start popping yellow and white and orange, I'll probably notice a ton more than I actually notice when they're green, to be honest. Hanging. I don't know if you can see that, but it's hanging in the corn there. That's kind of cool how it's growing off the ground. It's right in there. Oops, just about knocked over a pumpkin on the way out. Nothing like tripping on your garden. I never thought to just sell sunflower heads, but I suppose we could do that too. Some at a grocery store today and they were three for like 10 bucks. I always just kind of think of sunflowers as in the ground and pretty. I never thought to like bring them in the house. It was a weird thought that I never thought that. And sold them in three for 10 bucks. Big old bumblebee on this guy. Seeds. Look at them bees fighting over that one.